Get your decade ahead horoscope now at NadiyaShah.com. Hello, fabulous Scorpio. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of September 2019, looking at life and love. I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. And if you remember, late last month, I spoke about it then. We had and we ended that month with a beautiful new moon. Now, that new moon took place in a part of the sky for you that had to do with your connections to other people, friendships and group endeavors. Well, all of that very fortunate energy, very prosperous energy is going to be with you in the early part of this month. And so you might want to have a look at that again because you're carrying that energy into this month. But it is going to be mid-month that the energy will change, as energy has a way of doing, with the full moon. The full moon this month will take place in fellow water sign Pisces. Now, that in and of itself is great because it is your element, and it is an area where you're able to use whatever transpires to your advantage. And this is a part of the sky for you that has to do with what the heart wants in every area of life. It has to do with an awareness of what it is that you are passionate about. It has to do with children you want and children that you have, and it has to do with creative endeavors. So there's a lot of symbolism here, powerful symbolism, when we contemplate the heart itself and what it is that ultimately and how it is that it may speak in your life. The thing is that this full moon will be happening mighty close in the sky to Neptune, and it is going to be Mars that is standing across the sky from Neptune with precision under the light of the full moon. Now, these two planets, Neptune and Mars, will stand across each other once every 2 years or so. So it is a somewhat rare phenomenon, and it represents a time when emotions and desires may feel as if they are running very high. Now, it is, of course, the same part of the sky that was so wonderfully lit up in the early part of the month. Well, that is where Mars is going to be. So this friendship-oriented part of the sky, a part of the sky that has to do with other people, interacting with others, working with others as well on professional endeavors. Social events are covered here, but professional events as well. Wherever it is that you are gathered with others, well, that is where this part of the sky starts to make itself known. And it may very well be other people now who are part of raising your emotions, who are part of, whether directly or indirectly, or, you know, whether it's by pushing your buttons or whether it's more lovingly, more gently, which is also possible. It is going to be these people who ultimately get you in touch with what it is that you truly want. It is so important to trust. It is in trust that infinite possibilities start to open up to us. Now, it is also part of this energy that there might be something you are really wanting very much at this time, whether it is an opportunity, whether it is that it's something you want to have transpire, and perhaps someone that you know has a certain opinion about that, and you're not a fan of that opinion. That can happen under this energy. Now, of course, whatever transpires, it'll be fine. And it is ultimately part of you connecting with a deeper, more spiritual truth for you. The one thing to remember under this energy is that it is very changeable. What seems so obvious at first may actually be very different. And so that is something you want to take into consideration. I would say no big decisions where it comes to things, again, like your friendships, like your alliances, like your children as well, under the light of this full moon. Just give it a little bit of space. Things will start to look more clear within days. And that clarity is going to come thanks to Saturn. It is going to be Saturn and Pluto both speaking in harmony with this full moon that will bring in an element of stability and a more mature approach. And it is going to be just 4 days after the full moon that Saturn will officially go direct. This is a powerful omen for a sense of growing maturity and a sense of clarity as well as to the reality of the situation. There's just so much misinformation, so much fantasy, so much desire and dreaming right at the full moon that what is the case, what actually is the truth, may not necessarily be as clear as you may like, although you might sense that it's there. A more grounded perspective will come into the picture soon after that full moon. Chances are it is going to be as a result of either talking to someone like a sibling, a cousin, or a neighbor, or maybe just running into somebody kind of synchronistically that ends up giving you that more grounded perspective. It could also be information that becomes more clear, or documents or messages that you receive. All of this becomes an integral part in helping you to understand what's really going on, but more importantly, what really matters. Once you know that, everything else can just fall into place. Now, as we navigate towards the end of the month, that is when we are going to have this month's new moon. This new moon will take place in the sign just before yours. This is a part of the sky that has to do with what is deeply private, what is hidden, perhaps even from you. There's a sense of this part of the sky being intimately connected to what's happening on levels of soul and psyche and spirit. And that's why it speaks to the dream space for you as well. Well, this new moon will be standing across the sky from Chiron. Chiron, of course, is a planet that represents the wounded healer. And so this is an opportunity for you to heal, an opportunity for you to become more aware of where it is that you can cultivate a more healing energy within you. Now, Chiron recently moved into a part of the sky for you that has to do with your daily life. So in some way, the people that you interact with every day, well, that may be part of the awareness that comes now. For some of you, this could be a time when you feel as if a secret or something that you didn't know before, having to do with a coworker or immediate supervisor or a client or customer, becomes known to you. For others still, this is going to be more related to the task at hand, the projects that you're working on. And it could be that some role within your job does come to an end at this time, or comes to a close. Now, new moons always bring new opportunities, and there is that opportunity now for you to welcome in the possibility of the new and the next. And certainly this month is a strong month for that. Next month is even stronger with the new moon in your sign. What this new moon ultimately does is it helps you to create space for the new and the next to find you a month from now when we have the new moon in your sign. Now, the other layer to this energy as well is if it is that you know that you have habits that maybe aren't very good or aren't very empowering, this is where you realize where it is that you're ready to let something go. So part of the closure may be that you let go of a bad habit, something that might be undermining you or keeping you from feeling your absolute best. That can be a powerful form of healing in and of itself. Where it comes to matters of love, the first 2 weeks of this month, Venus will continue to move through a part of the sky for you that has to do with friendships. It has to do with groups that you belong to. So it looks like love and being social are very intimately tied together. But then we're going to have Venus move into the sign just before yours. This is a very quiet part of the sky, and love normally under this energy would become more private as well. However, while Venus is moving through this part of the sky towards the end of the month, is going to start to connect with other power players. So we're looking at connections to Saturn, connections to your ruling planet Pluto as well. That connection with Pluto is especially interesting because by that point, Pluto will be standing still in the sky. At the very beginning of next month, we'll officially go direct. Now, I'll be here to talk about it every step of the way, but for now, the thing to keep in mind is that there might be some very strong feelings playing out for you in the second part of the month, and some of it might be hard to put your finger on. If it is that you're open to meeting someone new, you've got beautiful energy in the first part of the month to connect with someone in a social setting, to feel a sense of lightness, to feel a sense of fun, which is a beautiful energy. However, as we navigate into the second part of the month, well, that is when what is happening in love? Well, chances are you're not going to feel like you want to shout it from the rooftop. It is possible that you may attract someone into your life now, but there are complicating factors. So whether it is that they are complicated or something's going on in their life, you may have to take that into consideration as you contemplate whether or not you want to move forward with this person. If it is that you are just starting to date someone, the first part of the month, very social, very fun. So make sure you're spending time with people that you know, with people that they know. It is in these endeavors that love is fostered that much more. However, in the second part of the month, the energy does change in meaningful ways and it becomes more private. And it can also be at this time that you become aware that there are other things going on in this person's life. For some people, it can feel a little bit like you're not seeing this person as much as you would like. For others still, it could feel as if you're learning more about this person and what you are learning. I wouldn't say it is a surprise, but it is of greater depth than you realized. Now, regardless of what shows up for you, know that there are also harmonious energies playing out here as well. It's not all just one thing. However, the later that you navigate into the month, well, chances are it's going to feel as if there's more and more factors there that you can't necessarily just tell everybody about, that you can't necessarily just take as lightly as you would like, but feel rather consequential. For those of you who are in an established bond, the first half of the month, social, fun, right? As I've been saying, that's really nice. Make sure you are nurturing the bond that the two of you share, doing fun things together. It is in the second part of the month that chances are you are going to want a lot of alone time with your partner. This isn't about talking about things and understanding, but rather it is about the soul connection that the two of you feel. It may be that the two of you are working on something in your own time, in your own privacy, and it isn't something that you feel you can share with others just yet. That time will come, but at least for now, you can cherish these quiet times together. What I love about this month for you, well, look, the first part of the month, very light, social, people tend to really enjoy that, which is great. But I do think that as we navigate later into the month with the intensity of the energy that is there, there is something that will be strangely familiar about that for you. You are diving into the depths of your soul. Chances are your dreams are going to be especially vivid now and especially revealing. And you may very well see things about yourself, about your soul and your psyche and your spirit that let you know how resilient you are, how strong you are, things that you can like and deeply respect about you. Well, thank you so much for watching. You can get a video like this every week by logging on to nadiyashah.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded exclusive videoscopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy.